Hello friends, today we'll take a look at the signature Acoustics Bluelink Bluetooth 5 bridge for signature Acoustics modular hybrid earphones. So these are modular earphones, so they can be it means that they have a modular design and the cables are removable, and we can use this accessory to convert these earphones into Bluetooth earphones. So I'll show you exactly how that all is done, and we'll also unbox this product right now and see what's inside. The fascia says just signature Acoustics accessories, and SA cable. We have an email here in case you need to contact the company for any reason. Okay, now let's just quickly unbox this and see what's inside. Okay, we are done. Okay, here we have the box. Okay, let us see what's inside. Okay, inside we have this very nice looking case and a user manual. Okay, I'll read the manual thoroughly and let you know what it says. Okay, seems pretty self-explanatory at first glance. Okay, here they have mentioned the chipset. Okay, power reserve is 23 hours, Bluetooth 5. Okay, here is how to connect it. These are all the functions on the control panel. And some specifications over here. Okay, I'll take a look at it and I'll show you. Okay, for the time being, I'll keep it to the side. This box looks quite nice. It has this very lively SA logo here. I think it looks nice and the material seems very well made, and it will, even if I press it, it's not yielding. So seems to be well made, and I'm applying quite a bit of pressure here. So there's no danger of the products inside being damaged, at least in my opinion so far. So let us see what we have here. Okay, here we have the Bluelink Bluetooth accessory. This is the blue, it says Bluelink SA signature Acoustics Bluelink over here. This is the battery module, this is another battery module, and here we have the control panel. This is the multifunction button, this seems to be the LED. Okay, this is the volume rocker and the buttons for changing the track. And this is the 0.78mm 2-pin connector. Okay, this is an important bit of information, because that way you can determine which cables which earphones can be converted to Bluetooth using this type of Bluetooth cable. This is a Bluetooth 5. This is the Bluetooth 5 version. Okay, it has two battery modules, as you can see, and the cable is it is nice, soft to the touch. So seems pretty all right at the moment. The reason why I'm checking how it feels to the touch is because people will wear this for 3-4 hours at a stretch, and it should not cause any kind of bruising when worn on the skin. So seems pretty nice. As you can see, it's very smooth and quite soft actually, but not cumbersome. I mean, it's pretty easy to handle so far. We'll see how that goes. Okay, this is the 0.78mm 2-pin connector, as I said. Okay, so now let me quickly convert this earphone into Bluetooth. Okay, to remove the original cables, you just have to tug on them very gently and they'll come out. That's it. Okay, now we'll remove the right side also. Okay, so now that we are done with these cables, let us put them to the side here. Okay, one very important thing that you have to pay attention to is to match the right polarity. So the left side should go, the part that indicates L should go to the left side. Okay, and here is how you insert it. This is the 2-pin cable, this goes in here. So that's it, you're done. And this is a very secure connection. See, even if I move it quite rapidly like this,
Okay, it's not coming out. So this is a very secure connection. You can be sure of that. I have tried such type of cables before, so I know it. And this one seems to be quite nice. So the right side goes to the right ear IEM. Okay, that's it, guys. Now we converted our wired earphone into Bluetooth. And judging by the specs, it says more than 23 hours battery life. So even if you use these for like 3-4 hours every day, you are good for 6 days. So you have to charge them just once a week technically. We'll see how all that goes. So we've converted our earphones into Bluetooth. And let me check the performance and I'll read the specs in detail. And I'll update you guys on the important bits. Okay, here it says IPX5 waterproof and dustproof. Okay, now this is very important, guys. The cable itself is IPX5 waterproof, but the earphone is metallic, and if I remove this here, it has a porous filter. Okay, so nowhere does if you check the earphone manual, does it say that the earphone is waterproof? So please do not wear this earphone in Bluetooth configuration and go dance under the rain, because the earphone is not waterproof, only the cable is. Okay, so this is very important, and I hope that you guys will take this information into consideration before making before deciding to go use these in the rain. I feel that if you use these for walking, jogging and other sorts of exercise, it should be fine. Okay, the earphone is not going to get wet, you know, and anyways, most earphones nowadays are like sweat proof. So I've tried it and it works all right. You can use the earphone while exercising, and it's all right. I'll go on record officially and state that it is okay to use these while exercising, but not when it is raining or when you are going for a picnic to a waterfall and some other places. Okay, here the cable length says that this is 950 mm. 950 mm, to be honest, seems like it's almost a meter, but this at first glance doesn't seem to be that long, partly because this unique shape which helps the earphone to stay securely in the ear. Okay, these are taking about 8 to 10 centimeters in my opinion. Okay, the curved shape of the wire, so that will not be dangling, this will go behind the ear. So you take about 8 to 10 15 centimeters has been reduced right here. And since we have two battery modules, so this will keep everything nicely balanced. Okay, but we'll check that when I'll show you that in more detail. Okay, here it says, what does it say? Effective distance is 10 meters, up to 10 meters. Okay, the music time is approximately 24 hours. It supports aptX, aptX HD, aptX low latency, CVC, SBC and AAC codecs. So all the Bluetooth codecs that are currently in use, it supports all of them. aptX, aptX HD and aptX LL are extremely high quality premium codecs. They are the best Bluetooth audio codecs that we have in circulation these days. And if this accessory is offering a battery life of up to 24 hours while supporting these codecs, aptX HD, especially aptX HD, because it consumes a lot of battery, it is a very premium codec. So that is, in my opinion, that is a phenomenal battery life. Battery life officially has been stated to be 240 milliampere hours, and the charging time is 3.5 hours. It seems alright. Weight, it's very light, as I said, it's just about 17 grams. And that's about it, guys. I'll learn more about this chipset QCC3034 and get back to you. Okay, guys, a couple things that I'd quickly like to mention are, inside this pouch here we also have a micro USB charging cable. It is short in length, a little shorter than I would have liked. I think this is about 15 centimeters maximum, maybe 18 centimeters. And this one will go into a charger or a laptop or any power source. And the other end will go into this micro USB charging port that we have on the control panel here. So this is I trust you guys to figure this out. I'm showing it here. Okay, so that is how you charge this device. Okay, now we'll see how to wear the Bluelink properly, and I'll also comment on its performance. Okay guys, I went and checked out what's the big deal about this QCC3034 chipset. Here it states QCC3034 chipset. So I went and figured out what's the big deal behind that. And it seems, first things, it is the flagship chipset of Qualcomm. Qualcomm is the world's largest chipset manufacturer. All your mobile phones have Qualcomm chipsets. It is the flagship in this in this Bluetooth chipset category. Okay, so it technically is the most advanced, supports all the premium audio codecs, and it delivers phenomenal sound quality. It delivers high fidelity sound. So this accessory, I believe, is geared towards audiophiles. So that is something that they are not willing to compromise on. That is sound quality. So if you want absolutely stunning sound definition without compromising on the convenience of Bluetooth, then this is something, this Bluelink is something that you might enjoy. And as I said earlier, aptX HD, aptX LL, these are premium codecs, and they are needed, and the chipset needs to support them, you know, if it wants to deliver high fidelity sound. And the unique thing that I found out about this QCC3034 chipset is that it is like a turbocharged engine, guys. Even though it delivers a very, very good sound and delivers astounding performance, it consumes very low battery. That is in a way a defining characteristic of this chipset. So it is like a turbocharged engine. It is very efficient, so delivers better than optimal performance and consumes very little power. So that is why this chipset, that is why Signature Acoustics has been able to squeeze out I actually spoke to the designers. They said this is the long playback edition, and they've been able to squeeze out 23 hours of battery life while supporting all the premium Bluetooth audio codecs. So this is how they have this seems to be very well thought out. We have chipsets 8675, also the CSR 8675 chipset, which is present in the Signature Acoustics Phoenix, also supports aptX HD, aptX LL. They could have used it here, and it would have been cheaper in a way, because QCC3034 being the flagship, I believe it cost them more to put that chipset in this module. 8675 would have been a tad cheaper. But still, they have gone with the 3034, the QCC3034. I believe that is to provide just unheard of battery capacity. You know, these two battery modules help. That 24 hours is, most earphones, Bluetooth earphones, they provide, if they are true wireless, in my opinion, 5 to 6 hours is the maximum. Most of them, they provide 3 or 4 hours technically. It does not even last that long, maybe 3 hours at the max. The wired Bluetooth earphones, the wired Bluetooth as in not true wireless, the ones that look like this, have at max about 6 to 7 hours. So 24 hours is 4 times that, or at least 3 times, even if the earphones, some of them, they do provide 8 hours. So 3 to 4 times of battery life, and along with such an advanced chipset, I think the sound quality technically should be extremely, extremely good. And I'll comment on that. Just give me a little while to check the sound, and I'll also demonstrate how to wear these.
Guys, now our friend Mohit will show us how to wear this properly, the Bluelink. Okay, so he stuck it behind his ear like this so that it does not dangle. And this can be tucked neatly behind the collar if you're going to wear it with smart casuals or formals. So that way it looks very nice and beautifully balanced. Okay, the microphone is right where it needs to be, right next to his mouth, and he can probably jump a couple of times in place or jog and the earphone will not fall out. Okay, so as you can see, it's it looks nice. In my opinion, I was a little concerned about the 950mm length, but having seen it like this, it looks nice in my opinion. Thank you. Okay guys, I'm done testing the Bluelink. I've tried it for a couple of days. There's no question of burning in this particular accessory, as the earphones that I'm using are already burnt in properly. In my opinion, the sound is very good. There is no, I did not feel any significant difference between the wired version and the Bluetooth version, which is a lot to say, because usually there is a little bit of loss in quality when you switch to Bluetooth, but this was not the case with the Bluelink. And I even gave it to one of my friends to test both the wired version and in the Bluetooth configuration, and he said that in fact he liked the Bluetooth tuning a little bit more than the wired version. So there's no loss in quality. I'd like to give these a thumbs up, guys. If you want to try them, go ahead and purchase them. In case you don't like them, you can return them. So which is highly unlikely. The only deterrent, according to me, is the price. It is a little bit dear, at slightly above 3000 rupees. Yes, the price is a little high, but we have to take into account the fact that this is truly the only product of its kind in the country. I have not come across many other Bluetooth bridges that enable users to convert wired earphones into Bluetooth. And secondly, even if they do exist, they do not offer such such a long battery life as this one. 24 hours is truly, it truly blows many other products out of the water. And secondly, the QCC3034 chipset truly stands up to its name and does deliver a really, really awesome performance. We also have to take into account the fact that the people who will buy this Bluetooth accessory are those who have already purchased the Signature Acoustics Raven or the Ocean Hybrid Modular Earphones, and they'll choose to buy it only if they like the performance of these earphones. So there's already a bit of trust in the brand before they go on to make this buying decision. So it is a niche product. Yes, it is a niche product meant for people who have already purchased these earphones. One more thing that I'd like to address here is, will this Bluelink accessory be suitable for other earphones which have 0.mm 2-pin connector? So yes, technically it should work, but I have been told that this has been tuned specifically for Signature Acoustics earphones. But technically, they should work with other earphones also. I have not tried them with other earphones, but I suggest you go ahead and try it anyway. In case the sound is not to your liking, or you feel that the product is not up to the mark, you can let me know in the comments below. Please note that the final output depends on the quality of the earphones that you are using and the driver configuration that the earphones have. So please take that into account. But technically, yes, I am quite optimistic that it will work with other earphones as well. Thank you guys. That was it. I hope you liked the video, and do share your opinion in the comment section below.